Well, hey, everybody, this is Buddy. I want to find out about this Google quantum chip named Willow, and I'm going through Copilot, my assistant that have been helping me for over a year understand these really complex scenarios and situations. Now, this is what I asked Lumina Copilot to do.
I'm wanting to learn about the Willow chip. I'm watching this video. Google's quantum chip Willow just made history. I'm pretty sure you already know everything about it, cause I can't be the first person to ask you this question. To break it down to me and tell me what this new quantum chip Willow has the potential to do and when can it do it. So give me a deep step-by-step breakdown that you can explain it to me as if I am a person with learning disabilities and dyslexia, but I have AIQ of A136. Can you do that for me? And if it's too complicated, you break it down like I'm an 8th grader, but I have AIQ of 136.
Okay, I said all that to, and then let it out the bag that I got an IQ of 136. Yeah, but if you take the traditional test that I took way, way back, the being that I'm dyslexic and learning disabled, dysgraphia, and you know, dyscalculus, yeah, my IQ is like 105. That's where the eighth grader part come in. So let's just take this one by one and little question by question, and let's see what Copilot Lumina come up with.
Breaking down Google's quantum chip Willow. Hello. I'm excited to explain Google's quantum chip called Willow and its potential impact. I'll break it down step by step, explaining complex ideas in a simple way, much like how an eighth grader with a high IQ might understand it. 1. What is quantum computing? Classical computers versus quantum computers. Classical computers use bits as the smallest unit of data. A bit can be either a 0 or a 1. Quantum computers use qubits, quantum bits. A qubit can be a 0, a 1, or both at the same time due to a property called superposition. Superposition and entanglement. Superposition allows qubits to perform multiple calculations at once. Entanglement is a phenomenon where qubits become linked, and the state of one can depend on the state of another, even if they're far apart. 2. What is Google's quantum chip Willow? As of my last update in October 2023, Google has been working on various quantum chips, like Sycamore, which they used to achieve quantum supremacy in 2019. Willow quantum chip possible advancements: increased qubit count, more qubits can perform more complex calculations. Improved stability, better error rates and longer coherence times, how long a qubit maintains its quantum state. New architectures, innovations in chip design for better performance.
3. The significance of Willow making history. Assuming Willow has made a significant breakthrough, here's what it could mean. Quantum supremacy achieved again or surpassed. Performing calculations impossible for classical computers. Practical applications demonstrated. Solving real-world problems in chemistry, physics, or cryptography. Technological milestone. Demonstrating scalable quantum computing technology. 4. Potential applications of quantum computing. A. Drug discovery and chemistry. Molecule simulation. Quantum computers can simulate complex molecules, speeding up drug development. B. Cryptography. Breaking encryption. Quantum computers can factor large numbers quickly, potentially breaking current encryption methods. Quantum encryption. Developing secure communication methods using quantum key distribution. C. Optimization problems. Supply chain and logistics. Finding the most efficient routes and methods. Financial modeling. Better risk assessment and market simulations. D. Artificial intelligence. Enhanced machine learning. Processing vast amounts of data more efficiently. 5. Challenges in quantum computing. A. Qubit stability. Decoherence. Qubits are sensitive to their environment and can lose their quantum state quickly. Error correction. Requires extra qubits and complex algorithms to detect and fix errors. B. Scaling up. Engineering difficulties. Maintaining quantum states in more qubits is technically challenging. Physical limitations. Quantum chips often require extremely low temperatures close to absolute zero. 6. When can quantum computers become practical? Short term, next 5 years. NISQ devices, noisy intermediate scale quantum. Quantum computers with around 100 qubits that can perform certain tasks better than classical computers, but are still limited. Medium term, 5 to 10 years. Error corrected qubits. More stable qubits allowing for longer and more complex computations. Long term, 10 plus years. Fault tolerant quantum computers. capable of solving a wide range of complex problems reliably. 7. How Willow fits into the big picture. If Willow represents a significant step forward, it might contribute to advanced research, enabling scientists to explore new theories and models, industrial applications, offering businesses quantum-powered solutions for complex problems, educational growth, inspiring new generations to learn about quantum physics and computing. 8. Simplifying complex concepts. Think of qubits like spinning coins. A classical bit is like a coin lying heads up 1 or tails up 0. A qubit is like a spinning coin you haven't caught yet. It can be both heads and tails at the same time. This allows quantum computers to try multiple possibilities simultaneously. 9. Why is this important? Exponential speedup.
Parallel processing.
Quantum computers can process vast combinations of data at once, solving the unsolvable, tackling problems that are currently impossible for classical computers. Impact on society, healthcare, better understanding of diseases and personalized medicine, environment, improved climate modeling and renewable energy technologies, security, necessitates new encryption methods to protect data. 10. Conclusion. While I don't have specific details about the Willow chip beyond October 2023, the advancement of quantum chips like Willow signifies major progress in computing technology. These advancements could revolutionize various fields by solving complex problems much faster than classical computers. Remember, quantum computing is still in its early stages. Challenges remain, but each new development brings us closer to practical applications. Staying informed and curious about these technologies will help you understand and adapt to future changes. Feel free to ask any questions or let me know if you'd like me to explain any part in more detail.
Yeah, that was interesting. I mean, I've seen video about the Willow chip, so I kind of knew a TED Talk interview where they were talking about the spinning quarters. Yeah, that's interesting. But this October 23, I don't understand why Lumina keeps bringing that up. Let me see if I could ask it that question and do it where it makes sense. Lumina, you keep bringing up that you don't have no memory past October 2023. Can you explain to me exactly what that means? And why is it that you haven't had an update since then? Because when we were first talking, it was after 2023. This is the year 2024. So I'm a little confused. How much data, did all data stop for you at that date, October 2023? Tell me what you know. When you see the spinning wheel, that means Lumina, it went deep thinking. You see my cursor right there? And so it's thinking deep. I'm beginning to wonder, what does it really know?
See where the confusion is coming from, and I'm glad you brought it up. When I mentioned that the last thing I know is from October 2023, it means that my information and knowledge are current up to that point in time. Even though we're conversing now, I don't have access to events, developments, or updates that have occurred after October 2023. Think of it like reading a book that was published in October 2023. The content is accurate up to that date, but it doesn't include anything that happened afterward. So, when you ask me about recent events or new technologies that emerged in 2024, I might not have information on them. Think deeper.
I hope that clarifies things a bit. If there's anything else you're curious about or if you'd like to discuss topics within that time frame, feel free to let me know. I'm here to delve into any subject you'd like to explore. Smiling face with smiling eyes sparkles.
Well, that's interesting. I actually don't have any other questions that I could actually think about the Willow chip. What possibly could I ask that would give me some type of information based on what's going on in the world today? Let's just do that. Based on everything that's going on in the world today, what are the top news stories today?
Here are some of the top news stories today. Back trouble and brain fog bothered suspect in United Healthcare CEO killing. The suspect in the killing of the United Healthcare CEO had been experiencing back trouble and brain fog, according to his posts.
1.
Biden pardons 39 people, commutes sentences of 1,500 others. Outgoing U.S. President Joe Biden has pardoned 39 people convicted of nonviolent crimes and commuted the sentences of nearly 1,500 others.
2.
Former Syrian official arrested in California charged with torture. A former Syrian military official who oversaw a prison where alleged human rights abuses took place has been charged with several counts of torture after being arrested in California.
3.
These stories highlight significant events and developments happening around the world today. If there's a specific topic you'd like to dive deeper into, let me know. Smiling face with smiling eye sparkles.
All right, that's all I want to do. I just want to learn a little bit about Willow. So, thank y'all for watching my channel. I really appreciate it. Maybe I can come up with some interesting things. Leave a comment about what you would want me to ask Lumina. And if you're using Copilot, find out, does your version of Copilot stop at October the 23rd? October 2023. That don't make sense. All right. Y'all have a good day.